Definitely, I am not equal to Vivekananda. So, it's a great pleasure to be here in the event conducted by my sister Raghvi, the Headway Foundation. I am also blessed to meet all my close associates here, be it Sathya Kumar or Kitty or anybody who I have met in the past many years in some of the events. And this event is close to my heart. When Raghvi called me and spoke about Inclusive India, I just asked her, is it like Make in India, Skill India, Digital India, Inclusive India? And I'm very happy. And I'm very happy. Already, I have this in mind that where I'm going to propose to the policy makers that Inclusive India is going to be another campaign. And the second important thing which I also wanted to highlight here, let's not use the word called differently able. Let's use the word called divinely able. And this should become a campaign around the world, and I give this responsibility to Raghvi to head this, champion this across the nation, called divinely able. Because the reason is, if you look at some of the people whom I interact with, whether they're physically challenged or differently able, they are, even though certain times they are having that kind of a non-inclusive feeling, but there are lot of potential on the other side. Let me give one case study. I actually met Mr. Sabri, who is one of the youngest scholar, I could say, he's from Coimbatore. I actually took him to the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu to introduce, because there are certain incentives available in the Tamil Nadu government, which the government is not actually providing to the differently able people, or not the campaign is going on, or the policy inclusion is not spoken to the people. Then I was interacting with Sabri on the way from the secretariat to the railway station. Asked Sabri, how is that you are able to remember everything? He's a visually challenged. He's a visually challenged kid. How is that you are able to remember all the quotations, the lessons? He got 484 marks in CBSE examination, standing 10th place among the other students also. He's a number one rank holder in Tamil Nadu in the CBSE category, state topper. He's a visually challenged from Coimbatore. Then he said, sir, God actually closed my eyes, but did not close my memory. He gave me enormous memory. This is the case study which I was speaking. And inclusiveness, it is not we who should not include them. They are including us, in fact. That's the point I wanted to make. And second important thing is that in 2007, it was a global dialogue. It's unfortunate to note, in 1995, we got the Disability Act in India. Every year, the government of India will amend the Income Tax Act. Every year, budgets are conducted for income tax purpose. But the government did not have time to amend the Disability Act. It took for them almost 20 years for the government to identify. It was 7 disabilities which was notified in 1995. Now it is 21. And the act that has been brought, I could tell you, the culture of India is not the act, bringing act. It was the British culture which we emulate now. Culture of India is Vasudeva Kudumbakam. The culture of India is Tattva Masi, the divinity within of a human being. And I think this act which is brought here is only in the papers. It cannot be really implemented. But all that I can say is, at least there is an act now. Now what can we do with this act? If you go through the act, it says, we have to enable and provide facilities for the people who are differently abled in the public offices. That's what the act says. What happens to the places which is private? Today this hotel is a private property and they are including certain facilities for the disabled, differently abled people. But it cannot be mandated, it should come with compassion. The compassion has to be promoted, more outreach campaign has to be brought in. Now how do we enable this situation in the country? Today I could tell you, our education system is such a useless education system, it's a national waste. Our education is a national waste. It does not teach what is compassion. It does not teach how to treat other human beings. It always teaches killing instinct. It does not talk about loving instinct. The killing instinct starts in the examination. When the other person in the examination says, are you studying? No, I did not study. But still you get first mark. The competitive, that is not meant for anything. And the next important thing is, people get gold medal in the outdated service. If somebody says there is a gold medal in mechanical engineering, I still feel very pity about it. Because in mechanical industry they teach about steam engine. Already you are thinking about bullet train. Electricity trains have already come. And this is a kind of an education model we have, and we speak about inclusive India. My vision to Raghavi Headway Foundation and all the people associated with this movement, we need to build a curriculum in the school level about inclusive India. Whatever it takes, policy change has to come to enable the kids to understand what it takes to be differently able. What it takes to be. It should not be in the dry books, text. It should be in the video model. Murals has to be created to show what it means to be differently able. I also went through a certain kind of an experience in my home. Suddenly when my mom actually fell ill, about 7 years before, with arthritis. Until that time, I did not experience what is this differently able people's problems are. But suddenly when my mom was not well with arthritis problem, and she was not able to get up, then I felt what could be the problem of the different abled people. The heart of compassion came because of my personal experience. Nothing can be a best teacher than an experience. So we should give that experience to the kid, make them feel inclusive. Inclusiveness of the differently abled people, social inclusion is very, very important. And that mental level inclusion is very, very important, not through speeches, but through actions. In fact, in India, we need not teach inclusion. It's all called, in Parliament of India, it is written as Vasudeva Kudumbakam. The entire world is one family. And that inclusion should come. In fact, that model of inclusion is what we want. That inclusion should become the household quality. That's very, very important. Today, abled people also fight and become disabled at home. So I was just thinking, I was just asking to one of the kid, when do you interact with the kid? The kid will say, when my father and mother is free, I will interact. That's not the kind of a relationship we have. So exclusion is already happening. It's just not with different people. So we need to bring an inclusive situation in the country, and whatever the efforts the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment is doing under the Government of India, the Disability Act, the delegation, implementation part is given to the state government. It is our responsibility, because I am not sure how the state government will implement this, the new Disability Act which was passed in 2016. According to me, the powers given by the parliament, the state government has to implement. It is a great opportunity to shape the policy. If it is Delhi, we have to travel to Delhi. But now the power is in the state government. So what we should do is, from the Headway Foundation, we should have a policy body which will talk about the inclusion. We will go on impact. The power of the government is, always I used to hear three models: government as a reach, NGO as a heart, corporate as an efficiency. All three doesn't come together. Government as a reach to the people, NGO as a heart of the NGO should come, then corporate as an efficiency. But if you look at, government is not an efficiency, but it has a reach. NGOs have the heart, but they don't have the efficiency of the corporate and the reach of the government. If all these three come together in Headway Foundation, where we go and impact the policy, that will be a great effort from our side. One impact per year is our vision. One impact per year, at least, from Headway Foundation with the government is our vision. We should promote these policies which are inclusive. But to summarize, today from 7 disabilities which was notified in 1995, 21 disabilities are notified. And the government feels it's a great achievement to include acid attack and Parkinson's disease. That is not the only disability. There are much more. Disabilities, and they say 40% of the disability. How do you evaluate 40%? I don't sure. It is able and disabled. That's all. What is the question of 40%? And how do you determine the percentage? And these are the things that the government should consider how to do practically. These are all Western models which will not be that useful to the country like India. It talks about the public building, then how do you mandate the private properties? That one thing. And it talks about the violation of any of the provisions. That violation attracts imprisonment and 10,000 rupees. There is enforcement has to be increased. There has to be special courts and justice delivery system for disabled people. If somebody insults disabled people, hurts disabled people, he cannot go and fight justice with the common man. For the common man itself, it is delayed. Then that's the question of we engaging. So there need to be specialized courts to actually look at what kind of empowerment can be done. And I saw the financial memorandum of the Disability Act. Financial memorandum of the Disability Act. There is no allocation by the central government, neither by the state government. Financial memorandum part of the act. So we need to say, but in a particular year, If the Tamil Nadu government comes out with a budget, we have to tell them 1000 crores has to be allotted for the disabled people. If they don't even allot, then that is a question of development for the disabled people. So we have to project that as part of the budgets, and the government has to think about it. As of now, the 21 disabilities which are notified are blindness, low vision, leprosy cured persons, hearing impairment, deaf and heard of hearing, locomotor disability, intellectual disability, mental illness, autism, cerebral palsy, muscular, chronic neurologic conditions. So there are 21 things which they have notified, but this is not enough. I think it is the society's responsibility. Apps cannot just enable the differently able. We have to enable through our social inclusion with a heart of compassion. This is the vision with which I want to close this, my introductory note. I'm sure, let's not call hereafter differently able, we'll call everyone a demon, divinely able, because they have a divine quality within them. That's the reason that God has given them as a special children in the world. And I also have a statistics which I wanted to mention here. Out of total population in the world, 1 billion people are differently able in the world. 1 billion. 80% are there in developing nation. In a developing nation, even ordinary people are suffering, then differently able people will suffer much more. Right? And India accounts for 1/3 of the global population. 1.3 billion population. The majority of the disabled people are in India. India is the agenda of the globe. Whatever is the problem in India is the problem of the world. Then the champions for change should emerge from India. Champions for change should emerge from India. I also close the session with Swami Vivekananda's vision. Vivekananda always spoke about upliftment of masses. He pointed a movement for leprosy. Today, India has declared as a leprosy-free state, a country to an extent, which was declared by the government of India recently, with a movement was started by Swami Vivekananda in 1901. And Sister Nivedita went on to take forward this initiative in Kolkata and subsequently spread across the nation. This initiative has to be taken. Everybody should champion at least one disability so that it becomes ability of the person, so that we can bring the inclusiveness. And this is the vision I wanted to share. Thank you.
Some of you want to ask questions.